Hello everybody, it's John. Welcome on back to the shop as we continue building the carburetor on the little Upshur engine, or a mixer as we talked about in the last section. In the last section you saw the body was drilled all the way through. Here we're going to go to the milling machine and just get everything set up, and you'll see how it was set up, measured side to side, drilled one size under, then gone through with a 1/8 inch reamer. And also just slightly look at some of the lathe work involved in making the 1/8 inch brass. There's not a lot of machine work in here. It's mostly just going to show you how I set it up to go ahead and solder the two pieces together and make sure that they were aligned properly all the way across. So join me at the lathe, the milling machine, and back at the workbench. As you can see, here I am at the milling machine, and I'm using a center finder just to get the center of the 1/4 inch brass carburetor body itself. And I'm just using a wiggler here with the DRO coming around to the other side. And of course, then I just split it in half and then come down with the center drill followed by a drill. Now, I've just got through drilling the hole. The next thing I'm going to be doing here is just going in with a 1/8 inch reamer. And as you can see, I'm tightening it up in the drill chuck. And I'm going to run this fairly slow. You can hear me cutting the speed down here. I'm using the cutting fluid A9, which is a specific aluminum cutting fluid. It seems to work really well on the aluminum. Go ahead and clean the reamer off and go ahead and get ready to take it out and see what the finished product looks like. Again, it's just a perpendicular hole and you just have to make sure it's all the way through. Okay, I've just got back from the milling machine by reaming out the 1/8 inch hole that goes across, and now I've got a piece of 1/8 inch brass that's going to go through here. That's these two pieces off here to the side. Now, this will have to be drilled all the way through, and then it has to be lined up all the way across. Now, first reaction would be is just drill it through and then put this piece out through there and solder it together. But you can't do that. It has to have that middle part in it that goes all the way down. Now, so as I said before, this thing has to be made into two pieces. So I'm going to take this piece to the lathe, and I'm not going to show this. It's going to essentially be exactly what I did here. It's just face off and drill, and then come back with the two pieces. But the first piece is going to be 1/8 by 3/8 of an inch long, and it's got a 1/16 of an inch drilled in, 5/16 of an inch, and then it's got a number 68 drill. So essentially it's going to be, you know, the inside of it is going to be kind of like this, and then it's got to come through with another drill all the way through, and that's where the needle will fit. So I'm going to take that to the lathe, and then I'll drill that first. Of course, I'm going to do the same operation as I did before, face off, and then come in and drill, and then come in with the number 68 drill, and that's going to be the orifice. And then the next one is, the next piece is a 1/8 by 1/4 inch long, and it's going to be tap 256. So that's for this piece right over here. Again, I'm not going to show that on screen. That's just straightforward lathe turning and drilling. So we'll come back when we get ready to put all this back together and solder it, and then I'll show you the next steps on it. I'm going to take a look at this section right here just so that you'll see how I made that needle. I've just got a 256 machine screw chucked up in there. I just cut the head off of one end of it, and I'm using a file to put about maybe a 15 or 20 degree angle on it. I forget exactly what angle the plans called for, but you can check your plans. Then I just go back over it with a little small needle file and make it as smooth as I possibly can. But that's how I made the needle. Okay, I'm going to zoom in here on a few things and just show you the parts that make up this mixer itself. And these are the five parts that do it. Now, I did not show all these machining operations. I did show how I put the needle on the needle valve, but there's a lot of different ways you can do this. The plans show several different ways. I just took a piece of round brass and then I did some knurling on the edge of it and rounded that off a little bit. And then I've got the two pieces here. This is the threaded piece, and then that's that piece right there. Now, what I'm going to do is I've got these cleaned off. I'm going to put these together with some Loctite. If I can get it to go in there. I'm just going to Loctite that in there with just a few threads. That's all I'm going to need. And now I'm going to, and this black thing that you're looking at here, this is some carbon fiber mat. If you don't have that, you can probably use wood. I'm going to soft solder this using acid core solder. You can use rosin core if you like, but I just have both, and I'm going to use acid core solder. So I'm going to use my torch, and once again, I'm going to Loctite this piece here in, and I'm going to soft solder these two pieces here with a little small torch. When it's complete, we'll come back together. I'm going to try to get this in the center of the screen and just remind you of a couple of things before you get too far ahead. Now, the short piece on this side over here, this is the piece that's got your threads on it. This piece over here is the one that's got the double diameter. In other words, this end over here has got a bigger diameter than this side over here. And remember, that's the side your needle goes in, and it's got, the, I think, the number 63 drill or something to that effect in it. Now, I'm just going to be using a pair of machinist clamps to hold this up, and it's sitting on a carbon fiber. Again, you can use wood if you have it available. Now, I'm going to try to crank it up and just see if I have enough heat in this little gun here, a little Harbor Freight gun to do this. I may have to bring out the heavy artillery here just a little bit, but it shouldn't take too much to get it going. All right, I believe that's good enough. Now I have fluxed this up pretty good. Kind of got a big gob of solder. We'll let that lay like it is and see what happens. I may have to do a redo on that one. There's your completed carburetor. Now a couple of things that more of an art than a science here. This little point here, this little needle, when you press it in, and you're going to have to take a chance that it's going to work. And if not, you may have to try something else. But if you've got a hard enough screw, and I recommend something like an Allen screw if you can find it. This is not. This is just a regular soft machine bolt, so it's even more scary. But what you want to do is wind this thing down to where it hits that jet in there. And again, this is where the art and the science comes in, because you can mess up too much there and not get a good fit. But you want to crank it down and shove that needle up in there just a little bit and make that needle fit and sort of shape that copper just a little bit, or brass that you have on the other side. And I just do that two or three times and then just blow through there and see when this is tight or closed off that you don't get any air leakage out of the ends of the carburetor. Well, that wraps up this section of building the carburetor for the little Upshur engine. I appreciate you following along. Don't forget to go down on the Amazon page below. That's where you'll find the gears for the engine, along with some other things that I might use from time to time in these videos. Until next time, when we meet right here in the shop from the Upper East Side of Texas. So long, everybody.